all my dear students.
I welcome you in the class of Economics in EBMIS. Our today's topic is Types of Economy. Dear students, the topic is concerned in both the classes Standard 11 and Standard 12. For Standard 11, it is given in the first chapter of Introduction to Economics in Microeconomics. But for Standard 12, it is related with the second chapter of Indian Economic Development, Indian Planning. Means, this topic is most important topic for both the group of students, Standard 11 and Standard 12. So, let us start the topic types of economy. Before starting the types, we require to know about the meaning of an economy. Dear students, economy is a system that provides living to the people. You can say a system that provides livelihood to the people. In simple words, a system that provides living to the people. To study about economy, we require to go through a system. System in which we can enjoy our livelihood. What are the system? It may observe our own life or activity in our society. Identify the system with which everyone belongs to. In our economy or any type of economy, the essential thing for survival of any individual is a family. That's why the most important example for better understanding of an economy is a family. Household economy. Also a family. But in our today topic, what we have to discuss? Economy of a country, like Indian economy. Aapki economy ho sakti hai, household economy, village economy. Indian economy. Global economy. Our topic is concerned with the Indian economy, economy of a nation. Being an Indian resident and citizen, we have to deal with the Indian economy. I like that we can discuss economy of United States of America, economy of China, Russia, etc. It's a system that provides living to the people. What the way to provide living to the people? To know about that, we require to know about certain functions performed by our economy, a system. What are the functions performed by an economy? As we studied before, production, consumption, distribution, exchange, etc. These are the economic activities performed by almost all the economy of the world. Doesn't matter whether we discuss about household economy or Indian economy. Indian economy, entire India को study हम करेंगे. यहाँ भी production होगी, consumption होगी, distribution होगी, etc. अगर अपनी family household economy को study करेंगे, same function performed by that unit of the system. Also indulgent production, consumption, distribution and etc. To water the system available in our surrounding, which provide living to the people, should be known as an economy. Our concern is the economy of a nation. See the different criteria you can use to categorize economy in different categories. After that, we may be able to categorize our economy. And suppose an economy like India, where most of the people engaged in agriculture activity. In any economy, more number of people engaged in agricultural activity, you can say the economy is agrarian in nature. What is called agrarian economy? It means agrarian. Economy. What the criteria? More number of people engaged in the activity of agriculture. That's why it's driven by agriculture. It's popularly known as agrarian economy. Economy of China. Most of the people engaged in the production activity in industry or manufacturing. That type of economy may be called industrial economy. Because industry is dominating in the field of economic activity. Most of the income and employment coming from industrial sector. That's why it's industrially dominated economy. Other economy, like United States, United Kingdom, Germany, France, Japan, etc. Most of the people in the activity or field of services. It's service-oriented economy, service-driven economy. Means what we observe by the different type of categories of economy. The activity which dominate in the field of economic act will be the base of types of economy. As like that, we have to categorize the economy according to way of economic decision taken by the people. अभी तक हमने जो स्टडी करी, इट वॉज बेस्ड ऑन द नेचर ऑफ इकोनॉमिक एक्टिविटीज परफॉर्म बाय द पीपल इन इकोनॉमी. बट राइट नाउ वी हैव टू गो टू कैटेगराइज आवर इकोनॉमी इन डिफरेंट कैटेगरी ऑन द बेसिस ऑफ वे ऑफ डिसीजन मेकिंग ऑफ इंडिविजुअल इंस्टीट्यूशन और सोसाइटी. On that base, an economy is categorized among three categories. First, free economy. Free or market. Capitalist economy. second year.
Resources are owned and controlled by individual group institutions who are authorized to take all economic decisions. Means, in the field of economic act, who dominates? The private sector, the capitalist. Socialist control, command, or centrally planned, controlled economy, command economy. These are the extreme name. Everything under the control of a supreme authority. Authority means monarch. Or mere group of experts appointed by monarch. हमारी अथॉरिटी किसी सिंगल पर्सन में हो सकती है या वो सिंगल पर्सन अ ग्रुप ऑफ एक्सपर्ट्स अपॉइंट कर सकता है टू कंट्रोल द एक्टिविटी. दैट्स व्हाई द टर्म हैज बीन चेंज, मीनिंग रिमेंस अनचेंज. एक इकोनॉमी हो सकती है जहाँ सोल कमांडर एक ही है, दूसरी इकोनॉमी हो सकती है कमांडर एक ही है बट एक्टिविटीज को कमांड करने के लिए डिफरेंट यूनिट डेवलप कर चुका है थ्रू द प्लानिंग कमीशन. दे कैन कमांड द एक्टिविटी ऑफ इंडिविजुअल और सोसाइटी. द नेम इज सोशलिस्ट मीन्स एवरीथिंग इज कंट्रोल्ड बाय सोसाइटी, नो इंडिविजुअल ओनरशिप, सोशल ओनरशिप और कलेक्टिव ओनरशिप. मीन्स ऑल द रिसोर्सेज ओन्ड एंड कंट्रोल्ड बाय गवर्नमेंट. मिक्स्ड इकोनॉमी, सिंथेसाइज्ड वर्सन, पार्शियल फ्री, पार्शियल कंट्रोल. इन दी थ्री टाइप्स ऑफ इकोनॉमी, फर्स्ट एंड सेकेंड, two are the extreme forms of economy, rarely to be found in the real world. Must listen carefully. First was free economy or last was socialist economy. These two forms of economy are extreme forms, rarely to be found in the real world. अगर आप वर्ल्ड के एक एक कंट्री को सर्च करोगे, रेयरली ऐसी कोई इकोनॉमी होगी जो प्योर फ्री होगी और प्योर कंट्रोल होगी. आज के डेट में ऑलमोस्ट ऑल द इकोनॉमीज आर under the mixed economy. But this is the demand of topic to study all times in the given situation. Therefore, if the most economic decision taken by private parties or business entities, we can say our economy is capitalist, market or free. याद रखोगे कोई प्योर कैपिटलिस्ट नहीं मिलेगा. हर कंट्री में कहीं ना कहीं गवर्नमेंट इंटरफेरेंस हो, बट जहां डिग्री ऑफ इंटरफेरेंस कम होगी इट विल बी कॉल्ड कैपिटलिस्ट इकोनॉमी. डिग्री ऑफ इंटरफेरेंस एक्सेसिव होगी, बहुत ज्यादा होगी, सेंट्रली प्लान कमांड और कंट्रोल इकोनॉमी. In decision making, both parties play their dominant role. Mixed economy. For example, economy of United States of America, European Union, Japan, South Korea, etc. The all economies are guided by market forces. These are the perfect example of capitalist free or market economy, because most of the economic decision taken by private parties. For example, you can write the name of some economic like United States of America, United Kingdom, France, Germany, Norway, Sweden, Denmark, Japan, South Korea, etc. These are the example of free economy or market economy. Example, USA, UK, France, for socialist economy, most of the economic decision taken by central authority like China, Russia, North Korea, it's Yugoslavia, mixed economy, through the Indian economy, it's our Indian economy. See, the example of all three in the current scenario of our global economy. Some are categorized under three, some are under socialist, and some economies under mixed economy. To differentiate between all three, we have to decide certain criteria or basis to distinguish. Have you noted it? So please see the difference. In free economy, resources, that is land, labor, capital, enterprise, all are under the control of private. Means resource किसके पास होगी? Individual. Individuals, groups, family, or private party, socialist, everything is under the control of government. Government or society. You can say collective ownership, sabki ownership hai, or everything is under the control of God. Mixed private and public both. Second, basis for decision for economic decision to earn profit, social welfare. Both social welfare and profit, both. Comment rule. No. Free play of market forces, non-interference. No. Interference. Coalition. Absolute control. So it controls. Government regulates. Market economy, non-interference, no interference of the government. Fourth, socialist, absolute command of the government. Everything, all the decision taken by government. But in socialist, decision taken by public parties, private parties, under the regulation of the government, government regulate kare. Control nahin kare, yeah. Sab kuch control ho. यह रेगुलेट हो. नेक्स्ट मेरिट्स व्हाट आर द मेरिट्स ऑफ दी थ्री मेरिट्स ऑफ थ्री इकोनॉमी. First, rate economic growth. Get competition. Competition. Rate social
and fear. Social welfare and economic growth.
Demerits of market economy. Depends on degree of interference of the government. Let us conclude our topic. I have decided some basis to distinguish among all three to make our topic more interesting to understand. The first base is ownership of resources. Land, labor, capital, enterprise, किसके पास होगी? In the free economy or market economy, there is individual ownership. Land, labor, capital, individual or household or groups of people के पास होगी. It means private parties के पास होगी. Everything is under the control of private sector. In socialist economy, there is no individual ownership. All the resources owned and controlled by government. In mixed economy, both are applicable. You can take example of Indian economy. Private BA or public BA. Indian Railway under absolute control of government. Roadways almost dominated by private sector. यहाँ दोनों एक साथ एग्जिस्ट करेंगे, को एग्जिस्टेंस ऑफ बोथ पब्लिक एंड प्राइवेट. स्कूल गवर्नमेंट की भी होगी, प्राइवेट की होगी. हॉस्पिटल गवर्नमेंट की है, प्राइवेट की है. ओके, नेक्स्ट बेसिस फॉर इकोनॉमिक डिसीजंस. इकोनॉमिक डिसीजंस कैसे लिए जाएंगे? गोल तो है कि मोर प्रॉफिट. और one more point, one profit, three place of market forces, three place of market forces that is demand and supply. Demand or supply milke decide karenge. अब अगर एन इंडिविजुअल यू हैव टू बीइंग अ प्रोड्यूसर यू हैव टू टेक डिसीजन विच टाइप ऑफ प्रोडक्ट वन के कैन प्रोड्यूस. मस्ट रिमेंबर दैट वेन एवर डिसीजन गोज टू द प्राइवेट हैंड्स दे हैव टू टेक ऑल द डिसीजन टू अर्न मोर एंड मोर प्रॉफिट. वो सामान किसके लिए बनाएंगे? फॉर हुम टू प्रोड्यूस? ओनली फॉर द रिच क्लास. who had the most paying capacity to purchase the goods and services to earn more income or more profit.
But whenever decision taken by government,
social welfare, weaker section, mass of the people.
In mixed economy like India, motive is both social welfare as well as profit.
Therefore, the most infrastructure developed by government. Road government banayegi, electricity government supply karegi, railway government provayegi, school, hospital, college, everything constructed by government for the welfare of society.
Next is role of government
in the types of economy. Free of economy, no role. We already discussed in introduction laissez-faire policy, non-interference policy. Ab the government, maan lo government hai hi nahi. Isme government ka basically two roles decide ki jaati hai. One, to maintain internal peace and safety from external forces. There are two things government can talk from. To maintain internal peace and safety from external forces. Other side, other countries attack nahi kare. Iske liye aap defense ko strong karo. इंटरनल पीस के लिए पुलिस जुडिशियरी कोई स्ट्रॉन्ग हो, नथिंग मोर. इकोनॉमिक डिसीजन में इनका कोई रोल नहीं.
बट इन सोशलिस्ट इकोनॉमी एब्सोल्यूट कंट्रोल.
गवर्नमेंट फार्मिंग भी कराएगी, इंडस्ट्री भी रन कराएगी, रेलवे, मेट्रो, एरोप्लेन सब कुछ गवर्नमेंट चलाएगी. गवर्नमेंट ट्रेड भी करेगी, गवर्नमेंट एक्सचेंज भी करेगी, गवर्नमेंट बैंक भी चलाएगी, स्कूल भी चलाएगी, हॉस्पिटल भी चलाएगी. मिक्स्ड इकोनॉमी गवर्नमेंट रूल्स एंड रेगुलेशन बनाती है, डिसाइड करती है वेयर सी रिक्वायर्ड टू प्रोटेक्ट द इंटरेस्ट ऑफ द पीपल. अगर कोई डिसीजन मास ऑफ पीपल से कंसर्न है, गवर्नमेंट वहाँ कंट्रोल करेगी. मास ऑफ पीपल से कंसर्न नहीं है, कम्पिटिटिव पीपल से कंसर्न है, प्राइवेट सेक्टर को फ्री कर देगी. मेरिट्स, व्हाट आर द मेरिट्स ऑफ दीज थ्री टाइप्स ऑफ इकोनॉमी? Must remember that there is no superior and inferior types of economy. Har economy ke liye alag alag ho sakti hai, but after all, you can conclude your remark which one is more superior. Merit individual freedom, to har individual ek dusre se competition mein involved hoga to prove his or her supremacy. Pure is this competition. Competition hogi. रेगुलर बेसिस पे नई टेक्नोलॉजी सर्च हो टू डिस्करेज अदर टू डोमिनेट इन द बिल ऑफ प्रोडक्शन. एक कंपनी नई टेक्नोलॉजी बना के लॉन्च करेगी और दूसरी वाली उसी समय से प्लान करना शुरू करेगी उससे सुपीरियर टेक्निक लानी है. बिकॉज द गोल ऑफ कंपनी टू गेट द लीडरशिप राइट इन द मार्केट टू डोमिनेट द मार्केट. दैट्स व्हाई कंपटीशन ज्यादा होगी, बेटर टेक्नोलॉजी भी होगी, ऑटोमेटिक रेट इकोनॉमी होगी. रेट सोशल वेल, नो कंपटीशन, एवरीथिंग अंडर द कंट्रोल ऑफ द गवर्नमेंट. ध्यान रखोगे जैसे ही गवर्नमेंट इंप्लॉय की बात होगी, वो जॉब ज्वाइन करते हैं उनको पता है कि अब उन्हें कोई हटा नहीं सकता है. वाई टू परफॉर्म? अगर आप सुपीरियर परफॉर्म करते हो, दूसरा इंफीरियर परफॉर्म है, दोनों की प्रमोशन रेमुनरेशन साथ साथ होगी. नॉट डिटरमाइन वेदर वन इज परफॉर्मिंग मोर और लेस. दैट्स इट. देयर इज नो कंपटीशन, इट्स द सोशल वेलफेयर. सी द रिजर्वेशन पॉलिसी ऑफ गवर्नमेंट ऑफ इंडिया, जिसमें क्वालिटी होगी उसको जॉब ऑफर नहीं होगी, जो डिप्राइव्ड क्लास का होगा उसको जॉब ऑफर होगी टू मेंटेन और वेलफेयर ऑफ सोसाइटी. Again, economic growth since some activity undertaken by private sector. They are doing to earn more income, more profit. That's why it's also leads economic growth. Demerits. What are the demerits? The first demerits of free economy is the inequalities. The motive of all the producer to produce the product for each class, not the poor class. It's wide the gap between rich and poor. Rich becomes more rich and poor becomes more poor. who will be there to care about the interest of common people? Nobody. Because government adopted non-interference policy. That's it. It's wide the gap between rich and poor. It's inequalities. Social economy discourages competition. Government control and no need to compete. No need to indulge in any gap competition. Discourage competition. Competition ka bo inferior technology. Inferior technology, lower production, lower employment. Girls. Since government officials authorized to take decision, but nobody is unaware regarding the corruption in government offices. Red tape jam. The government officers are appointed to serve the people, but what they are doing? They are getting served by the people. बने हैं दूसरे को सर्व करने के लिए, खुद की सर्विस दूसरे से कराई जा रही है. That's why it's less corruption, red tape jam, etc. In next economy, these are depends on degree of interference. Government कितना interfere कर रही है, excessive or less? अगर गवर्नमेंट की इंटरफेरेंस एक्सेसिव है तो सोशलिस्ट इकोनॉमी की डिमेरिज काम कर जाएगी. लेसर फ्री इकोनॉमी की डिमेरिज काम कर जाएगी. मस्ट रिमेंबर दैट देयर इज नो स्पेसिफिकेशन. इट्स वेरी फ्रॉम नेशन टू नेशन ऑन द बेसिस ऑफ डिग्री ऑफ इंटरफेरेंस. अगर डिग्री ऑफ इंटरफेरेंस एक्सेसिव है, गारंटी है एक्सेसिव है, तो कंपटीशन डिस्करेज होगी, करप्शन बढ़ेगी. अगर गवर्नमेंट का इंटरफेरेंस कम से कम है, नॉट के बराबर है, इनइक्वालिटी बढ़ेगी, प्राइवेट सेक्टर को फ्रीडम होगी टू अर्न मोर इनकम, मोर प्रॉफिट. नथिंग मोर. इट्स ओवर फॉर टुडे. थैंक यू ऑल. वी विल मीट इन द नेक्स्ट क्लास विद द नेक्स्ट टॉपिक. थैंक्स.